I'm here with the victorious Manny Gamburyan, who just defeated Michihiro Omigawa. Congratulations on your victory. After fighting him, how do you say, like, what are your thoughts over Omigawa now?
Beast. One word, he's a beast. Phenom, dude. That guy is just, you can improve a lot of places in the game. You can never improve your chin. That guy has a chin for days. I punched him so hard, and I kicked him so hard, and he just got rocked, wobbled, and he came up and goes, punch me again. Really? I mean, you can't take anything away from this guy. He's just a phenom. He's just tough as nails. He surprised me. I swear to God, he surprised me. I'm still shocked.
Yeah, you know, I was noticing you guys were keep on going back and forth. It looked like he caught you one time, you caught him. It was going back and forth. Was there a time that you actually thought you were going to finish the fight early?
Oh, yeah. When I hit-kicked him, I'm like punching him. I just look at him. He's trying to punch me back. He's not even defending. He's trying to punch me. Come back with combinations. So I didn't want to rush my guy. You know, I got to take my time and just pick my shots, which is I did. And then I went for a takedown. So try to control him. But he's tough as nails. Tough as nails. Wow. Give him props.
You know, just you're telling me it's almost something that you didn't expect from him, right?
No.
You think you're going to, like, change your game plan now?
This is what I expect from him. I knew it was going to be a tough fight. I knew it was going to be a tough veteran fight. But one thing surprised me. He didn't change. He was southpaw for the whole fight. I was kind of surprised. I'm like, really? I mean, I worked both ways, southpaw and regular, but the guy just came up with southpaw. That's it. All fight, whole fight.
Yeah, I noticed he got you a little bit in your face. What round was that?
First round. Yeah, he clipped me pretty bad over here. I mean, I checked and got his eye not broken, but whatever. I'm a fighter. I'm not a lover, so it's all good. But
it is or isn't broken? I can't
believe it. No, it's not.
Oh, it's not. Oh, good.
It's not. He goes, okay. It's pretty swollen. Yeah. It takes probably 2 weeks, 3 weeks to heal up. I mean,
you know, I did notice in the weigh-ins that Ronda Rousey, the champ, was there with you. Are you planning also to be on her weigh-ins there at Strikeforce? I think it's the 18th of this month, right? August 18th?
Ronda is my girl. What are you talking about? I've been training with her for 15, 16 years now. I known her when she was young like this. She was always a hard worker. I used to work her with every single day. I used to do judo against with her maybe twice a day. When she was 16 years old, she was already a beast. She knows what's up. Yes, I'm going to be her fight, and I'm cornering her. Some of the girls that hate me because, man, you only talk about her. No, I mean, I seen her. I work out with her. She's a very hard worker, very talented, and she got heart of a lion. You kick her, you punch her, she'll come back with thing, like Omigawa. She'll come back.
There you go. Hey, you know, you've been actually fighting for years, and you said this is your first time in Los Angeles, right?
First time in Los Angeles. I've been fighting my first MMA fight was when I was 16 years old in Tijuana. I wasn't allowed to fight. So I'm like, after that, I fought a lot of in San Pedro at Kaja's show, underground. Then I don't even have my records, which is I don't care. But never in LA. I'm like 10 minutes away from here.
Yeah.
So it's home crowd. Doesn't get bigger than this. You know, end of the year, I want to, you know, just heal up a little bit. You know, today it was kind of war, but I just want to take like 2 weeks off, relax my muscles. I've been training like 2.5 months for every day, twice a day. Just my body's burned out, so I just got to rest. At least a week and a half, go back to my roots again, train. But I wouldn't mind fighting in November.
Oh, there you go. Even in November, you already put it out there. That's good. So, you know, how many more wins do you think you need under your belt for you to finally face some Jose Aldo?
Like I said, there's a lot of very, very good 145ers out there. I can't pass one another. Whatever the UFC wants, whatever Dana White, Lorenzo, they want me to do, I'm down to do it.
You're ready whenever?
Whenever.
Well, congratulations on your victory, and we wish you luck.
Thank you very much.